Welcome to this Oceanic Plus tutorial. In this tutorial, we will learn about the decompression algorithm used and the advanced gas settings of Oceanic Plus. Within the Oceanic Plus ecosystem, your Apple Watch Ultra and your iPhone use the same Bulman ZHL16 decompression algorithm and feature a familiar graphical interface across both devices. This consistent visualization has been key to making your dive simpler, allowing you to focus more on enjoying the dive. The algorithm most commonly used today is Bulman. We use the model ZHL16CGF. ZHL stands for Zurich limits, and because Bulman was Swiss and carried out these studies in Zurich, the 16 refers to the 16 theoretical tissues in the body. C is the version of the algorithm studied for dive computers, and GF stands for gradient factors. I'll give you a quick overview of how it works. Of the theoretical 16 tissues in the body, whichever one is getting closest to its supersaturation limit at any stage of the decompression is the controlling tissue, and it will dictate when you stop. The algorithm therefore takes into consideration all tissues in the body, both fast and slow ones. The behavior of the slow tissues is very different from the fast tissues. During your initial stops, the fast tissues tend to release gas, while the slow tissues tend to continue to on gas, having the risk of ascending beyond the supersaturation limit. And it is for this reason that gradient factors have been implemented. This algorithm calculates if and when you need to perform a decompression stop during your dive. The way that Bulman decompression works is that you ascend until the tissues hit their supersaturation limit. At this point, you should not ascend any further, because the tissues will become more supersaturated than Bulman theory believes you should allow. So, if you stop at that depth, this will be your first decompression stop. At this depth, as you wait, that tissue gas pressure will fall. And then you can continue ascending, and you hit the limit again and stop and wait. And then ascend again and stop and wait and so on, until you can surface below the maximum limit. To quickly understand what it means to use gradient factors, or GF, with a Bulman decompression model, you'll need to choose two numbers. First is the GF low, and the second is the GF high. The first lower number is what controls the deeper stops, or the depth of your deepest stops. So if you choose the default 70-85 option, that means you can ascend until you develop tissue saturation of 70% of the allowable Bulman limit. That will become your first stop. Notice that while you are performing a decompression stop, the supersaturation levels in your tissues begin to fall. Then as you ascend, you can see the opposite occurs. The GF high is the fraction or percentage of the Bulman limit that you will allow when you surface. Hence, the higher the GF number, the shorter your decompression time will be. For example, a GF low of 30 will have a deeper first stop than a GF low of 70. Whereas, a GF high of 70 will have longer stop times than a GF high of 85. That's just an introduction to gradient factors and not a substitute for proper dive training. If you want to learn more about decompression diving, we recommend you take a certified course from a recognized training agency. Oceanic Plus provides the flexibility to choose a variety of preset gradient factors to allow either a more liberal or conservative approach to optimize your dive plan depending on personal preference. And as a reminder, you can change these settings on both the Apple Watch Ultra and the iPhone version of Oceanic Plus. In the Dive Settings menu, select Scuba Diving, then select Conservatism, then select Algorithm Factors. There are three predetermined conservative settings based on your diving style. The default setting is 70-85, which is the least conservative but provides the user 15% conservatism. By choosing a subsequent option, +1 or +2, you are further increasing your conservatism level, which will increase any deco time if required. The +1 option is 65-80, which provides 20% conservatism, and +2 option is 60-75, which provides 25% conservatism. In general, the more conservative the dive, the less likely you are to experience decompression sickness. You can also avoid getting out of the water with more nitrogen saturation, reducing common post-dive fatigue. Lastly, there is a custom option, which allows the user to customize the low and high gradient values. This allows you to create an even more conservative approach to your dive plan if desired. However, we recommend if you do not have training in the use of custom gradient factors to not proceed here. By regularly monitoring your no decompression times during a dive, you can easily avoid entering decompression. However, if you find yourself staying longer than planned or needing to exceed your no deco limit, a yellow no deco mode alert will be displayed. The consistent use of these colors throughout the application aims to maximize safety and familiarity with the application. Let's have a closer look at how decompression is displayed during a dive. On your descent, you will notice your no decompression time available will begin reducing. This is the amount of time you can stay at your current depth before entering decompression. Just below it is the tissue loading bar graph, which is also decreasing as depth and time increases. As the dive continues, it is important to note that your no decompression limit time will continue to reduce as you absorb more nitrogen. By starting your ascent before your no decompression limit time runs out, you will avoid entering mandatory decompression. However, if you exceed your no decompression limit, your device will enter deco mode and a deco mode alarm will display, followed by directions to ascend and stop at your deco stop. Once the time has ended, it will display the next stop depth and time, providing an ascent profile to off gas prior to exiting the water. Now that we have given you an overview of the Bulman algorithm and decompression within Oceanic Plus, let's look at the gas options. Oceanic Plus is capable of both air and nitrox gases enriched with oxygen up to 40%. Once you know the gas mix for your dive, you can set it on either device by selecting Settings, Dive Settings, Scuba, then Gas. You can choose the right mix. If choosing nitrox, select nitrox, then select the FO2 or oxygen percentage of the gas. Next, you can plan your dive time and maximum depth using the No Deco Planner. Here you can enter when your next dive is expected, the gas mix used. In this case, we'll select nitrox 32%. Notice the MOD, max operational depth, of the gas displayed is 111 feet. By entering how deep our dive will be, you can see the resulting no deco time. The default max PPO2 for your dive is 1.4. With Oceanic Plus, our ecosystem enables simultaneous use of your devices, allowing syncing of dive settings and changes to your algorithm, gas, and other configurations. Thank you for watching this tutorial. You can get additional info by watching other tutorials or going to our website at www.oceanicworldwide.com/Oceanic Plus. Enjoy every day, every dive with Oceanic and Oceanic Plus.